Welcome back to Living Local. The second oldest children's theater in America has never experienced a crisis like COVID-19. However, the Davenport Junior Theater is finding ways to adapt so it can continue giving kids the opportunity to express themselves with confidence and creativity. Joining us in studio today, we have Daniel Sheridan. He is the Performing Arts Supervisor with Davenport Junior Theater. Daniel, thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me back. Looking forward to talking.
So, like so many of us out there, we've all had to adapt to the circumstances surrounding this pandemic. So, how has the theater adapted to COVID-19?
Oh, wow. So many changes. I mean, on March 16th, when we closed our doors, we were in the middle of a camp, in the middle of a session with 500 enrollments. And so wrapping that up, and we sort of took a two-pronged approach. We wanted to make sure that theater was immediately accessible and free. So we started a YouTube learning channel that people can access on our website for free. And then we also started setting up virtual learning spaces, and designing these teaching spaces for our teachers to reach and impact our kids.
I love that you guys prioritized making sure that it was a quick kind of turnaround. I'm sure like everyone, it all happened very quickly, and we all had to really pivot and shift our normal workflows. Tell us a little bit more about this free learning channel and what makes it so special.
Yeah, so the Junior Theater Learning Channel is a collection of theater and dance classes, tours throughout our facility, which is just a wonderful space, and also performances and a huge variety of learning opportunities. Also, it's kind of a great chance to explore if your kids will connect with our virtual learning spaces as well, but no cost, which is nice.
Oh, fantastic for all families out there. How would you describe the response to your first four-week virtual session in June?
It was fantastic. We pride ourselves in having a constant dialogue and communication between our parents and our users. And the feedback from them was outstanding. 95% of them said they had an excellent or above average experience. So we were really proud about that. And our setup, we're using multiple cameras and really keeping the flow back and forth between the kids engaging. And I think that makes them feel like they're actually there at Junior Theater, which is really important for us.
I think that engagement word is so key here. I know for a lot of folks staying at home, kids are out of school, really difficult to stay engaged when we're social distanced from everyone in our normal routines and activities. So what an incredible resource to get kids up, getting them being creative and getting them plugged in with other kiddos as well. What are the fundamentals you are trying to teach kids, and how are you still meeting those goals, albeit in a different way?
Well, I would say whether it's our theater program or our dance program, it's really about instilling a confidence in the kids to communicate with clarity, but also be comfortable within their own bodies and occupying their own spaces. And right now, in our current state, it's also about just having fun and feeling like you're having fun with other kids and with a teacher. Because if you're not having fun, you're not learning. So that's our primary focus right now, is joy in the classroom space, but also, teaching them about themselves and who they are and how they can communicate.
Everything you just said there, I hope folks out there understand the massive value that theater can provide to especially kids, and all those amazing benefits that you don't even necessarily even think of firsthand, but being comfortable and confident in your body, that is a huge role in theatrical performance. Can anyone be involved in these virtual sessions? How does that work?
Yeah, I do just want to comment too, before the segment, you and I were talking about how we're both theater kids ourselves.
We are.
Love the arts. But kids ages 3 to 18 can engage our programs. Our June session, we offered over 50 classes, things from hip hop to ballet to acting to improv. So really, anybody can sign up and anybody can join in. And we still keep our class sizes small. We don't have like 20 or 30 kids in the classroom. It's usually about 8 to 10. So we still get to know every student, which is a priority of ours.
That's fantastic. Daniel, why do you think that providing theater experiences for kids is more important than ever right now?
Well, I mean, just because the venues changed to the virtual space, I mean, our kids today are going to be having to master that space going forward in the decades to come. So trying to role model for them how that communication works and getting them engaged with one another, maybe in a way that's different in the school learning setting, so that they can, experience storytelling in a new way.
Now, Daniel, arts organizations right now really do need support. How can our community help the Davenport Junior Theater?
Well, I always say, and I believe it, that the most important thing is just letting somebody you know who has a kid that you know has a heart to express and engage to tell them about our program. Mm-hmm. And then secondly, right now, Junior Theater Incorporated, our nonprofit entity, is doing our annual campaign where people can give and support the theater company itself. And you know, those contributions go to things like we recently did a mailer to all our students in the last year of a special packet that arrived at their home for free with videos and crafts and activities just to keep them learning. And those are the kind of things we're able to offer because of the support in the community.
Oh, that's wonderful to see that kind of support. Daniel, thank you so much for all the updates about what's going on with the Davenport Junior Theater and also for your enthusiasm for the arts in our community. It really does make a difference.
Yeah, it's a blessing, and thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Well, if you guys would like some more information, you can visit DavenportJuniorTheater.org. We'll also have those details posted on OurQuadCities.com.